Yes. All right, well, let me move on. I'm done with the show. Okay, so good job, guys. Thank you very much for being on. I got honorable mentions though, a couple of them. So I think the first one comes from NXT, so we're staying on NXT. It's Javon Evans and Wes Lee. So they had a match which involved Rob Van Dam, Robert, or Vlad. I don't know if you know this. You didn't see this, but RVD was in the angle, and they had a backstage thing where Wes Lee like beat him up as he was trying to get him out of the way so he's not involved. You know what I mean? And then he went out for his match with Javon Evans. And this is my crazy spot of the week. Last week I had botch of the week, but this week I had the crazy spot of the week. So watch this, Vlad. Here's Javon Evans going through the ropes after Wes Lee, who's by the announce table.
To get out of the ring. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Evans looking to fly.
No. So there you go. He fucking flew, oh, through the ring ropes. He's trying to get at Wes Lee, and I'll put it in slow motion this time. And he flies over Wes Lee and into, like, over the announce table. This guy looks like he could be a fucking basketball player and do a slam dunk, and flew all the way over the announce table. I don't know if I've ever seen that. But that was fucking nuts. Anyways, the finish of the match was that Wes Lee was going to use the steel chair, and Rob Van Dam's music hit. So even after getting beat up, he just hit that pipe and came back out, and that was enough of a distraction to.
You're absolutely right. Exactly what he did.
I mean, it
Make
must.
sure it's clear. It's not the crack pipe.
Yeah, weed pipe. Weed
Well,
pipe.
yeah. I mean, everybody knows. I
Yes.
know. Everybody knows RVD's history with, and love of weed.
All right, so yeah, it was the ECW night, as we mentioned earlier. So that was another guy. Rhino also showed up. I didn't like the Rhino segment. And then what? Oh, the Nunzio one. That was my other honorable mention. Vlad, you watched this and you saw Nunzio and you changed the channel. Are you kidding me? Anyways, no, Nunzio and Tony Mamaluke, they found Tony D'Angelo and the family while they were out buying ice cream, and he said Nunzio told him that you disrespected me by not calling me back, because he called him last week and he never got a call back. So because of that, he used his stroke to get a North American title shot. So yeah, I was tripping out. I was like, what the fuck? Nunzio's out here with a North American title shot in 2024 on NXT. He's out here kissing guys and everything. Come on, Vlad. How could you not like this? I thought Nunzio was the best guest star out of all the old ECW guys. I didn't really like Bully Ray's segment. Bully Ray, he was all right. I know it didn't really. D-Von was there too, Vlad. Bully
D1,
Ray and D-Von. So yeah, this was Nunzio's like one of his spots off the top rope. Like for an older guy, that's kind of crazy. You know what I mean? But yes. So this was the ending though. He took a slam off of Tony D'Angelo, and that was it. I mean, I thought it was a well-worked match for an old guy, Robert, right? I mean, what did you
Wasn't
think?
that?
We both gave it a thumbs up, and then they gave mutual respect at the end. I thought it was cool. I actually thought it was nice, Vlad. I thought it was nice that Tony D'Angelo helped Nunzio work a match that looked kind of realistic and decent and give him, like, one last spot on a WWE show that was pretty good, so.
I guess, but I mean, I don't know. It's just kind of weird. It was just a weird.
Sentimentally, it was. I mean, it was a well-worked match, Robert. I mean, it all made sense. None of it seemed weird and out of place, I think. I mean, he got a couple shots in, he tried, and then he lost. So
Right.
that was that. And then.
I guess it all makes sense when somebody named Tony Mamaluke is involved, but whatever. I throw my hands in it. I'm not involved in this. I
Well,
am no connection
it
to
was a one
NXT.
time it was a one time thing one time thing but
Meow.